Talking about decision making, for centuries it has been all about information, getting as much information as possible. And this is because what we were doing was called solo thinking, solo decision making. We're trying to get as many bits of information as possible and to reach the best decision. In the recent years, with the emergence of social networks, we got this amazing new thing called the wisdom of the crowd, which is basically the fact that collaborative decision making based on the information that a multitude of individuals have can outperform the decision of the most capable member of this crowd. Of course, the danger in this is to do it in a too extreme way, when what we would have is groupthink, the elimination of diversity of opinions. In our study, we had data from a social trading platform called EToro. And basically what EToro is, besides the social network and the financial investment network, is the fact that it's giving its users the ability to follow other members of the community. So it's basically like Twitter, but you can follow people with your own money. And of course, when someone makes bad investment decision, you may stop following them and start following someone else. The cool thing about it is the fact that it transforms the investment to a collaborative decision-making problem. We have all the information that the entire community is exposed to, and the interaction between them generates the sentiment, the crowd sentiment, which is basically the result of this collaborative decision-making process. The network has roughly 3 million users, which is enough to enable those network processes. The question, of course, that we ask ourselves is, does this thing work? Can it improve the trading performance of the members? What we see here is the performance of the eToro users normalized in a way that filters out the market effect. We see that at first, the performance is marginal, even negative, namely taking place in this process actually harms your performance. But as time passes and the network grows and becomes more complicated, the performance increases. However, it is still very volatile, and it's very hard to say at what day joining the network and putting your money at the hands of your peers would result in higher performance compared to just, you know, following the index, the market index. And this is because this process is very chaotic and it involves many bits of information flowing around the network. What we see here is the trader network. Every dot here represents a follow link between two eToro users. For example, this dot here means that the user here decided to follow the user here, this user. And immediately we can see what is called the gurus, leading traders. Those are the horizontal lines we see in the network. This is basically the adjacency matrix of this network. And what we can also see is this clog over there, which is what we call an echo chamber. This basically means that a group of Tor users followed each other excessively, resulted in an information cascade that eliminated the minority opinions. When you look at the data, the actual data, the performance data of the network, you see that it also resulted in a severe loss of funds, very bad investment decisions. In our work, we took the network and was able to formalize it into one number we called the cascade probability, and to also bound this number by what we call social friction and social conductivity, which are measures of the network itself. So we can look at the network, and the network, remember, it's dynamic. It changes constantly. We look at a snapshot of the network and can say what is the current probability of information cascades. So now let's see what happens if we take the information cascades and see how it influences the performance of the network. This image here shows us the return of investment of an average participant as a function of the cascade probability, and each dot here represents a day. So as cascade probability changes, we move on the x-axis, and the y-axis here shows us the performance. And what we see is that when cascade probability is too low, we get very poor performance. This is because many users are isolated and are not exposed to enough information. They may think that they are following other members of the community, but they're not getting enough actual information. We can show mathematically that this results in a lot of noise being amplified in their decision process. And as the network becomes more and more complex and dense, performance starts to increase. However, when it's too dense, we have too many edges in the network, performance starts to decline as well. And this is because we have what we call feedback loops. And basically, it's the same information circulating in the network over and over again, being amplified, and again, causing a decrease in performance. And now, when we saw this result, we ask ourselves, so how can we help those traders and this this platform? And we conduct the field test when we actually gave the EToro users some free money, free investment coupons, but the investment coupons came with the recommendation. Use this money, but we recommend that you follow that user. What this actually does is add new links to the network and alter its structure. And in order to do it scientifically, we had two control mechanisms. First, random recommendations, and second, recommendation to follow the best performing traders. And the results were quite amazing. Here we see the performance of the investments. This is the day of the intervention when we send the coupon. And we can see that we were able to decrease the cascade probability as intended, and had a huge increase in the investor's return of investment. Actually, the return of investment was doubled in the week followed the experiment. And what's interesting to say is that this was also more than twice the effect achieved by giving the recommendation to follow the best performing traders. The way the information propagates is more important than the source of the information itself. And this is, of course, statistically significant, and we can significantly enhance the performance of traders and platforms. So we founded the Athena Wisdom, and the aim of the company is to create smarter crowds, wiser crowds. The technology is network tuning, when we can moderate and control the information flow and information cascades, and thus enhance user experience, which ultimately also improves the revenues of the operators themselves.